And here are some local corporate headlines. Cebu Landmasters enters a joint venture with international commercial properties developer NTUD to develop premium-grade residential towers in Cebu City. The companies are preparing their formal notifications to the Philippine Competition Commission. Meanwhile, PetroSolar Corporation signs a power supply deal with Shell Energy Philippines. PetroSolar will supply Shell Energy with clean power from its solar power plant in Tarlac. And Lucio Tan leaves his post as director of the Philippine National Bank as he shifts into a new role at the bank's chairman as the bank's chairman emeritus. PNB also has two new additions to its board, its former chief strategy officer Chester Luoy and former Management Association of the Philippines president Eusebio Tan.
Asian markets ended Friday trade on a mixed note in a week marked by interest rate decisions. The Nikkei 225 shed 0.5%, even as the Bank of Japan left its benchmark rate unchanged. Now, this is as the country's August inflation data showed the consumer price index remained above the bank's 2% target at 3.2%. Private sector activity there also expanded at its slowest rate since February. Meanwhile, Chinese markets surged following a report by Bloomberg. Regulators are considering lifting limits on share ownership by foreigners. As for the ASX 200, it eked out a gain, helping reverse losses for Australia, a 6.5% jump in shares of Costa Group, the country's biggest fruit and vegetable company. That's after its board accepted a $963 million takeover offer from a consortium led by U.S. private equity firm Payne Schwartz. Here at home, Philippine shares picked up gains, with the main index climbing for a second day to post a weekly gain. But at least one analyst sees more sell-off ahead, citing uncertainty in domestic economic conditions.
I'm open to the possibility that we could still test lower lows. That could be exaggeration from lower liquidity, lower volumes in the market. And at the same time, you know, we still have some index stocks that haven't actually gone down. There is still largely that uncertainty that that has been pervasive in the year. At the same time, though, we are already seeing the trend going down for inflation. Core inflation is telling you a lot more, rather than headline inflation. The BSP is still confident about the 2-4% target. And along with this, we have international targets, international agencies also telling us that, you know, our growth looks intact. We even got that upgrade in outlook, in rating. So at this point, we think that the market should be aware of the uncertainty and know the risks when getting into the market today. At the same time, we highly encourage everyone to look at the medium term and long term outlook that is quite positive if you take a look at the macro view.
In news overseas, Singapore-based Foodpanda is reportedly conducting its latest round of layoffs and is in talks to sell part of its food delivery business in Asia. According to CNBC, Foodpanda's Asia-Pacific CEO confirmed in an email, the company's priority right now is to become leaner and more efficient. As being agile remains critical, the job cuts come as Foodpanda parent Delivery Hero also confirmed with CNBC that it is in preliminary talks to sell part of its Southeast Asian food delivery business, which also operates in the Philippines.
The launch day of the iPhone 15 met with a not-so-festive mood in France and China. Some Apple workers in France began a nationwide strike Friday over pay and working conditions. About 30 workers formed a picket outside a store in central Paris, just a few meters away from a line of customers waiting to enter the shop. More workers belonging to other unions also plan to strike on Saturday. They're asking for a 7% wage increase to compensate for inflation. They also want an end to a months-long hiring freeze. Now in China, Shanghai's flagship Apple store saw long queues of people picking up their iPhone 15 pre-orders, but many were largely unimpressed by the phone's new features. One disappointed customer who has been upgrading iPhones every year for the past 10 years says he might just stop doing so next year.